Good morning, students. In last class, we discussed about human reproductive system in female as well as the structure of male gamete, that is sperm cell. Also, we have discussed. In this part, we are going to discuss what is happening during sexual intercourse. That is, we are going to discuss under this part. So, as you have seen that now. So, we have seen the structure of the male gamete, that is sperm cell, and this is the head part, as you have seen under the structure of the sperm cell, and this is the female egg cell, and both consisting of nucleus. What are they consisting of? Both they consisting of nucleus. In sperm cell, the nucleus is present in the head part, and here the nucleus is present in the egg cell. Now, what is happening here? During sexual intercourse, that is the during the process of sexual intercourse, during sex, where the male and female organisms are participated in the sexual process. So, what is happening here? The male organism, they deposit or add or releases male gametes in the form of semen. And this is semen consisting of male gametes called as sperm cells. What do they consisting of? Sperm cells. So, these sperm cells which are released or deposited in the female body by the male gamete. What is happening here? These travels through the vagina. The sperm cells travels through the vagina and reaches into the fallopian tube. Fallopian tube. So, where it is reaching? Fallopian tube or oviduct. Why it reaches to the fallopian tube? And here one more thing we have to remember. See, during the sexual intercourse, the male organism, it deposits some millions of sperm cells during one ejaculation. Means, ejaculation means one deposition process, millions of sperm cells are deposited. But out of millions of sperm cells which are deposited, only one will be reaches to the ovum. Then what happens to remaining others are? So, remaining all, what is happening here? Finally reaching to the fallopian tube, some of the sperm cells are going to be degraded due to the acidic condition which is found in the vagina. That may causes to killing of the sperm cells. And only few, some thousands only finally reaches to the ovum. Out of all these thousands of sperm cells, only one is going to hit to the egg cell. And what is happening here? It starts going to fuse with the egg cell. That is important. So, these sperm cells which are collected into the vagina, they travels to the fallopian tube or oviduct. Why they reaches to the oviduct or fallopian tube? Why? Because as we have seen that, in the structure of the female reproductive system, so what we have seen, the female during sexual intercourse, the ovary adds or releases the egg cell. So egg cell is collected into the fimbriae. From the fimbriae, the egg cell is traveled and reached to the fallopian tube. There it will be waiting for the sperm cell. So, the sperm cell now which is deposited in the female reproductive system, they travels towards the fallopian tube. Now, the sperm cell is traveled to the fallopian tube. Here, the sperm cell is traveled. Now, what is happening here? This sperm cell consisting of nucleus in the head and the egg cell also consisting of nucleus. Now, what is happening here? The head part consisting of acrosome. This acrosome degrades the outer membrane of the egg cell by the enzymes which are present in the acrosome, and this deposits the nucleus into the egg cell. Now, the new egg also consisting of one nucleus and the sperm cell egg also deposited. Now, see. Actually, how many nucleus are present in the egg shell? Only one nucleus is present. After deposition of the nucleus, a single cell consisting of to nucleus. And what is happening here? The male gamete and female gamete, they both fuse together. And this process is called as fertilization. What else it is called? Fertilization. And the terminology we have discussed, that's what. And the terminology earlier, we gave the terminologies all. So what is fertilization? Is fusion of male gamete and female gamete. Then what it is called as? Fertilization. So after fertilization, what is happening here? Formation of a zygote is occurring. What is occurring? Zygote is occurring. So what is zygote? So zygote is nothing but the male and female after fusion, and which is consisting of a dinucleus condition of this cell. Di means two nucleus condition cell. Then what it is called as a zygote. This zygote consisting of one is a male organism, that is ovum nucleus, and another consisting of male sperm cell nucleus. And this which is consisting of two nucleus in a single diploid condition it is called. If one cell consisting of two nucleus, a single cell consisting of two nucleus, this is a single cell. And which consisting of two nucleus, and this condition of the cell is called as a diploid cell. What does it is called? Diploid. Why it is called as diploid? So it consisting of two nucleus, a single cell consisting of two nucleus, and such kind of cell, what it is called? Diploid cell. And this is called as zygote. Now the formation of zygote, where it occurs? In the fallopian tube. Where does it occurs? In fallopian tube. That's what we said. The sperm cells are travels to the fallopian tube. Now, what is happening here? The zygote which is formed in fallopian tube, that travel downwards to. That is, now the zygote is formed. This is the zygote. Diploid cell, it is zygote. This zygote is collected into the muscular bag. What it is called? Uterus. Muscular bag, what it is called? Uterus. Now here the zygote is collected. Now the zygote which is collected before going to reach here, it is developed into a ball like structure called as a morula, which consisting of many cells. And that many cells containing ball-like cell structure, what it is called? Morula. So various stages are found. So this is travels to the embryo, sorry. It travels to the uterus, where if you observe the structure of the uterus, it is made up of tribune membrane structure. It consisting of three membranes. So these three membrane muscular band, it is playing a key role by outer membrane is called as endometrium. What it is called? Endometrium. When the zygote is collected into the uterus, the endometrium becomes thick. Why? Because it should bear the weight of the fetus. That is embryo. That is the growing baby. Weight should be carried by the uterus. So the outer membrane, that is endometrium, will become thicker, and it supplies the nutrients for the growing of the baby. So for this going, the growing baby which is collected, that is embryo which is collected into the uterus, it starts growing a connection in between the wall of the uterus, and the embryo. In between there is a connection will be forming. The connection which is forming in between the uterus and the embryo is called as a placenta. What it is called? Placenta. Placenta is a physiological connection. What is? It is a physiological connection which is formed in between the embryo and the mother's uterus. And what is the use of this placenta? The placenta is only the connection or supplies the nutrients from the mother to the baby. So how the baby getting nutrients means
by the connection of the placenta, it supplies oxygen, it supplies blood, and also it supplies nutrients.
Oxygen is supplied, blood is supplied, and also nutrients are supplied for the growing baby. That is what importance. Not only that function. The baby or fetus releasing waste, nitrogenous waste substances also collected from the embryo or from the growing baby and send into the mother blood through this placenta. That is the waste also collected. And carbon dioxide which is produced by the fetus or embryo, that is also collected and sent out of the embryo. That is what the placenta is, a physiological connection which is formed in between the uterus and the embryo, and that supplies the nutrients, oxygen. At the same time, it collects the nitrogenous waste and other waste substances like carbon dioxide and removes from the growing fetus. That is what. And this connection, once it is formed in between the uterus and the embryo, and that process is called as implantation. What is this called? Implantation. So what is implantation means? So zygote, the zygote or embryo which is going to attach or connected to the uterus by means of placenta. And this process is called as implantation. This implantation makes to grow the baby in the uterus. That's what the uterus is also called as a womb of the mother. So from the earlier menstruation and earlier in the formation of zygote and growing of complete baby, and this period is called as gestation period. What does it is called? Gestation period. Gestation period means the period in between the embryonic development stage, that is zygote stage, to the complete young one development stage in between. That process, what it is called? Gestation period. The gestation period in human beings, especially in human beings, female, around 40 weeks or 9 months. 40 weeks or 9 months. That is the mother is carrying a baby. That is the time duration. So, the baby, expelling of baby out of the mother womb, that is called as a pasturation. What else it is called? Pasturation. So, pasturation is nothing but giving delivery to the baby. That is what we can see, that pregnancy is nothing but attaining or carrying a baby, that is the pregnancy. And gestation means the period of zygote to the delivery, that is called as gestation period. And pregnancy means carrying a baby. These are the various which we can see under the process of fertilization, which is occurred in female body. This is what another concept.